In Audio Views, Audio Media Rep Part 74, Orla from Dairy Girls. This show is great and I really enjoyed it. If you're unfamiliar with it, it's basically a coming-of-age sitcom about a bunch of teens in 90s Northern Ireland, aka the times of the Troubles, and about how even in basically wartime, kids will still be kids and go through the same awkward life phase as everybody else does. I really liked the lightness and the general juxtaposition of how life just keeps on going even as the world seems to fall apart around you and literally anything can become normal after a while. Anyway, I've gotten at least 50 requests to review Orla, thank you. What I love about her is that she is really confident, not just in the sense of like, oh, I don't care what other people think of me, but more in the sense of not even realizing that other people think weirdly or badly of her. She's just existing on her own path, and if people want to join her in it, that's cool. And if they don't, she's going to keep on doing excessive amounts of step aerobics anyway. This is also a very niche thing, but a lot of autistic people tend to move differently because of various comorbidities like hypermobility and dyspraxia, and she has that slightly gangly, floppy physicality, which made me feel very seen in a way I can't explain. She's also a very literal thinker, often misses social cues, including really important ones such as, hey, maybe don't waltz into the bathroom unannounced and stare at Aaron in the tub, or straight up imminent danger. Like a lot of times she just puts herself in really weird, dangerous situations because she's just going about her life as she wants to go about her life without realizing the surrounding everything or like long-term consequences of those actions. She's delightful chaos, and honestly, I strive for that. We all should strive for that.